So, we're going to start a new island, as I have a new Switch to replace the old one, and people have wanted to see more of animal content. Specifically this, and since the old VODs were lost to time, and I ran out of hard drive space and couldn't store them, yeah, here we are. This game was great in 2020. Oh no, there we go. Cool. I'm saying that the story here is the mayor, me, was evicted from New Leaf because the residents thought that I spent all of the town's treasury on a gigantic golden calendar. That's how New Leaf ended. And so now, I had to leave. I was facing impeachment, so here I am at the airport heading to an island somewhere where no one can find me. Let us be the first to congratulate you on your wise decision to sign up for this adventure. Welcome to the check-in counter for your deserted island getaway package. We're so much to look forward to, but first let us introduce ourselves. I'm Timmy with Nook Inc. And I'm Tommy. We'll be flying to the island with you to get help you get settled. I can't read today. Think of us as your partners. We're in it for the long haul, so let's get started, shall we? The first step is checking your application. Is this your first time applying for one of our packages? Yes. Understood. Now, then, we'll need to look up your application. Name and birthday day. You can't change this. This can be seen by others during local or online play. So pick an appropriate name. It's fine. I'll be boring. Don't include personal info or offensive words, but my name is personal information. Sure. I love how they say don't include personal information, but they're like, name and birthday, please! Yes, here you are. Our next step will be to take a picture of you. Don't worry, take as much time as you need. Ready when you are. Okay. I mean, I would say, like, I'm not white, but I'm not... Yeah, I mean, that tone's correct, I think. There's not enough hairstyles to begin with, so... Have a square nose. I'll just go with cartoon. I think that's fine. Nah. Sure. That'll do. Great, you're all set. All set. I'll just go ahead and add that picture to your records. Nose reveal? Yes, I have a square nose. Circle nose, you got me. Now let's start talking about your new home. So exciting, exciting. You see, we're quite proud of the work we've done to help you feel comfortable in your new life. Oh yes, in fact, if you want, you can even experience the seasons the same way you used them. What I mean is, we have islands in both the northern and southern hemisphere. We recommend choosing an island that is the same seasonal pattern as your current home. Where do I live now? Oceania. Excellent. That information really helps us focus on the right island for you. So naturally, we'd recommend that you relocate to an island in the southern hemisphere. There are a few more decisions to make, but does that sound okay so far? Yeah. Very good. We have a number of lovely, uninhabited islands in the southern hemisphere to choose from. Now then, all of our islands are approximately the same size and they're all quite natural, bro. Quite natural islands, indeed. So don't worry about whether you'll have enough space or comfort. You can't go wrong. Just follow your instincts and choose an island with a layout that looks appealing. That's how I do it. I'll show you some maps now, and you can choose the best one for your new home. New home. Yeah, the old natural bros are... It's pretty normal. Alright, I guess what do we want? Which island? I mean, I think if I don't want any of them, I can get them to change it, like... The design is very human. What do you mean is very... What's very human? Number two. Number two is very human? I don't see it. What makes two human? Is this a Rorschach test? I'm just not seeing it. Oh, when someone calls it natural. Okay, sorry. I thought you were referring to, like, the design of the island. Although, now that I think about it, the bottom right one, if you really have, like, a brain that's in the gutter, you could argue it has, like, human features, but let's just not go there and pick number two. Wonderful choice. I can't wait to show it off to you. Ah, but before we depart, I have just one final question for you. If you could only bring one thing with you to a deserted island, what would it be? Food. How interesting. Oh, I'm sorry, that was just a hypothetical question. Nook Inc. will fully cover all your basic needs. Yes. Paquete de escapada, Islas Desiertas. The chartered flight for Nook Inc.'s deserted island getaway package is ready for boarding. I don't know why they have it in Spanish. Any customers waiting to board should make their way to the gate at this time. Ah, perfect timing. Come on, let's all board the plane together.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for taking this chartered flight as part of Nook Inc.'s deserted island getaway package. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy a complimentary video presentation about deserted island life.
Ah, I've missed this music. This music's great. You know, not narrated. Also, I have enabled the channel point stuff for this game, so... On the note of art, if you want to submit art for my house that I hang up, just use the tool that I linked in Discord, or, like, it's in the channel redeem thing. But, yeah. I'll hang it up. But only once per stream, so it's one redeem per stream. And you have to have the art ready. I got cherry on my native one, and I got cherry in New Leaf as well. So, both times cherry. It's Peaches this time. Alright, something different. Excuse me, who are you? Is that a Power Ranger? We're here. Now I know you must be incredibly excited to explore your new island home, but I have one small request. Would you please join us for a short orientation session in the nearby plaza? Our fearless leader himself will be giving a presentation, so I'd hate for you to miss it. We're heading there right now if you'd like to move. Who are you? Rocket. Come on, we gotta follow the guides. I got an ape called Rocket and a mouse called Moose. We gotta get a move on, come on. Oh, it doesn't let me pick up steaks. Alright. Is that everyone? Let's see. Is Rocket here? How about Moose? And there's Will, of course. Great, we're all here. I'll turn that over to you, Mr. Nook. Our three adventurers are ready to get started. Yes, yes, very good. Let's see, how shall I begin? Of course. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to your new island. My name is Tom Nook, and I'm the founder and president of Nook Inc. Yes, yes. Today is the first day of your new life on this pristine, lovely island, so congratulations. And this is a package deal, huh? As such, Nook Inc. staff will always be here to support you and ensure your comfort and safety. But first things first, yes, yes. I'd like each of you to choose a spot of your own. It's the first step to putting down some real roots. I'd like you to dream big. I do have certain connections in construction and real estate and... but I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's just get started with a simple tent, shall we? Please collect your tent from Timmy or Tommy and then choose a spot to place it. Am I going to allow myself time travel? Well, it's already been done because... I just put the clock 12 hours back. Because if I started now, there would be nothing for me to do as it's nighttime. I'm not going to skip days at a time. I'm just going to play this like you would, just time-constrained. I'm not going to skip. Your very own tent. Alright, cool. Once you find the perfect spot, press X and place your tent. Don't worry, you'll get a chance to see what it looks like before making a final decision. You'll want a little breathing room, so take your time finding a spot that works for you. Oh, I suppose I should probably set you up with a map, too. Once you've put up your tent, please find your way back here. Use your new map if you need it. Well, off you go. I hope you find a great spot. Yeah, I'm just using the time skip to not play in the dark all the time. But so the only one I'll allow is... if I need to play at night, I'll just change the time zone back to my normal one. But it's not going to skip a day, pretty much. If that makes sense. Just getting used to the controls again. There it is. I'm thinking where I should put my house. This doesn't seem like a bad spot. Oh, there's like a central island thing. That's interesting. Hold B to run. Oh, no, no. I'm not holding B to run on purpose. Because I want to catch bugs, so if I stay running, I'm just never gonna catch bugs. The first time was, yes, I didn't realize it. This time is by choice. Yeah, I mean, I think here's fine. I mean, what I mean by here is, like, hugging the edge. Hold on. Damn, I didn't... It's not gonna sit flush with it. Otherwise, I mean, here also works. Just as long as it sits flush with the river, that's what I want. There we go, that'll do. Catch my bugs out. Well, not now, I just mean... It's just getting my mind ready, so I don't constantly run. Set up my tent. That's a big first step. I mean, I kind of like it. This is fine. Ah, well, you must have found a suitable spot for your tent, hmm? You're the first one back, so I suppose the others must still be searching for the right location. You know, since you've already done some scouting, the others may appreciate your assistance. Yes, yes. Yeah, I'm going to assist, for sure. Yo, Moose, you're Will, right? Nice to meet you, Shorty. You, Shorty? You already set up your tent, eh? I'm trying to find the perfect spot. I'll be doing some serious cardio, so it's gotta have lots of fresh air. I think the spot will do the trick, but I don't know. What do you think? I'll find you a spot. What? You'll help me find a sweet spot to put up this tent? Seriously? Wow. We just met and you're already doing some heavy lifting on our friendship. Well, okay then. Can't wait to see the spot you pick out for me. My tent is in your hands, Shorty. You got this. If you need me, I'll be over at the plaza visualizing how awesome island life is going to be. I want to see this mouse's face. Have I thought of a theme yet? Not yet, no. Oh, that's an interesting face. So I'm gonna design this in a way where it's... You know, we want to keep like a pretty uniform neighborhood, I think. I'm gonna be thinking about how this is gonna look overall. Imagine if someone said that. Well, I'm not saying it to a person. That's just... That was not a face I was expecting. So I wanna afford myself like a backyard. So I mean, it's probably not the worst thing in the world if they go here. Okay, so let me just make sure that it's in line. Alright, so from here, walk across. That looks in line to me. The other one I'm gonna place in line with this building, but then up here. This tree's in the way, which is unfortunate. Where's Rocket? Yo, wait, I got it. Don't tell me. You will, right? See? Told you I had it. I'm Rocket. I gotta tell you, I'm excited to do this whole island thing. Vroom! You already found a good spot, huh? I was trying to feel for the best spot, but I'm having trouble because every spot feels like the best one. Couldn't just sit here thinking it over, so I just grabbed a stick and threw it. And here's where it landed. So this is my spot. Okay, I know. There's only so far I could throw the stick, but I'm liking this. I'll show you a good spot. Oh, for real? You're gonna pick a perfect spot for me? You do that for someone you just met? You know, you're alright, Will. In that case, here you go. It's your show now, Broom. You pick out the perfect spot for the tent I gave you. I'm gonna wait at the plaza in the meantime, okay? Okay. Well. Pretty much. I guess we'll go with here. Just let me get it right. It's like... Does it need to be a cross one, or am I wrong? Let me imagine it. It needs to be a cross one. You really don't like the monkeys, so you're mad there's one on your island. I don't know how I feel about Rocket yet. We'll see personality. Okay, that'll do. That's fine. And we'll cut down the trees. Rocket's got a place for her tent now. Looks like everyone has a spot picked out for the tents. Need to go back to the plaza. Okay. Welcome back, everyone. I hope you found just the right spots to set up your new homes. Of course, you can sleep on it for a while, hmm? Really get a feel for how it suits you. And with that taken care of, we can move on to the serious business. Like throwing an island warming party, we'll have it right here in the plaza with a roaring campfire. We'll just need a few supplies to get started, yes? Since we'll all be living here together, this will be a good test of our teamwork. Let's see. Timmy, Rocket, Tommy, and Moose can set up things at the plaza. Meanwhile, Will and I will work on gathering firewood and perhaps a little snack. Alright, everyone, let's get to it. Will, would you come see me for a moment? What are you thinking? Please check with our boss. Okay. Ah well, I just wanted to go over what we'll need for the campfire. I think roughly 10 tree branches should do the trick. You can find them scattered about the island. So when you find one lying on the ground, press Y to pick it up. Meanwhile, I'll investigate the peach-like items growing in the trees. I suspect they're real peaches. Peach-like items. Yeah, I mean, this would be spring, so... It's a different season to when I started playing. Which would have been... In summer? Yeah, it would have been summer, because there were sharks, so... It's spring here. Whoops, I got weeds. It's okay. See how much I can get done. I'll get some extras because then I can get crafting on like a fishing rod and all that stuff. Thank you. I should have enough by now. Yeah, I mean, it's a very skeptical face. Look at that face. That's why I said interesting face. Yeah, that face. Just perplexed. Alright, that should be enough. Oh, good, good. Well, looks like you managed to collect up the tree branches, hmm? You found even more than I asked. I only need 10, but I'm sure you'll find a good use for the rest. I'll take what we need off your hands now. Yes, yes, that should be plenty for our campfire. You made quick work of that. I'm quite glad that I'll be sharing this desolate island with such a hard worker. Ho ho! And speaking of surviving on a desolate island, our next task is to round up something to snack on. While you were collecting branches, I was evaluating the fruit that seems to be abundant here. They look like peaches, they smell like peaches, and they even taste like peaches. In fact, they are 100% without a doubt genuine peaches, so will you collect 6 of them for me? Now, I'm sure that you don't need much guidance here, but just in case, if you see a tree growing peaches, press A to shake it, then just pick up the fruit. I'm sure you'll have plenty of peaches for us all in no time. Fine. It's actually useful weeds. Alright, I'll do it. Well, well, I knew you were the right one for the job. Thank you once again. I'll go ahead and take those peaches off your hands and get started on the preparations. Now, is that everything? Yes, yes, I believe it is. Let's get started with the festivities. Sorry, did it just make it nighttime conveniently? I guess time hasn't started yet. At last, allow me to properly welcome you to our new island, or Union Island. I have participated in many ventures and endeavors over the years, but this may be the most exciting. Helping develop a thriving new community entirely from scratch will truly test my business acumen. And perhaps my skills as an outdoorsman, Oh well. Now, we may not have the kind of numbers that I originally envisioned, but that just means we'll have to rise to the challenge. And I have no doubt that with hard work and perseverance, we'll shape this deserted island into... I suppose we can't call this a deserted island anymore, What should we call it? Okay. I sense a great opportunity. As the first residents of this island, we should be the ones to name it. And in the spirit of democracy, we should put up a vote. Majority rules. So take a little time to think, and when everyone's ready, I'll present your ideas. Okay. Well, you know, the original island was called Shambleton. Oh, wow, that doesn't work. I think I ran into this problem as well. What am I gonna call this island? I don't know. You can't change this. What is, like, present? I don't just want to call it the same thing, that's just lazy. It's interesting you can use symbols. I should have made that a channel point thing, like name the island. What's like, okay. What's a three-letter suffix you can add to this? Hmm. It's like 10 o'clock at night. My creativity is out the window. Ish? No. Wow, I really don't know what to call this. Is there like an island generator? Like a name? I can come up with a random name. I blew the remaining of my creativity and problem-solving in Tunic earlier. I might just have to call it the same thing. I can't think of, like, a better thing. Okay, that works. I got it. I got there in the end. Let's try saving all our ideas at the same time. Ready, go. Guitar Barra. Isla the Biceps. What splendid variety. Yes, yes. Each one a potential gem. Now for the voting. I'll say each name in order and you can clap for the one you think is best. Will seems to have the enthusiasm and naming sensibilities. Let's start there. So Will suggests Sir Shamblonia. I don't even clap for my own thing. Wow, that's an overwhelmingly positive response. Each and every one of you clapped, except me. I suppose if everyone is in agreement, we should just go with Shamblonia. Sounds great, it rocks, absolutely. Splendid, and from now on, this island shall be known as Shamblonia. Well, Will, since you've proven yourself by naming Shamblonia, I'd like to rely on you for other critical decisions we'll need to make on this island. Yes, yes, I hereby name you the resident representative of Shamblonia. Will, could you please say a word or two as a new spokesman for your neighbors? A word or two. So, we've settled on a name for our island, and we've selected our resident representative. It's been a big day, but it's gotten rather late, so let's have a toast. Oh man, I kinda want that milkshake. Everyone have a beverage in hand? It's fresh juice made from peaches our resident representative harvested on this very island. Then without further ado, a toast to Shamblonia and the happiness of its residents. Cheers. I just wanna... just position myself so then thumbnail is easy to make later. I don't have any emotes yet, I don't think. Okay. Well, from what I remember, let's just move on to the next day. I will, having a good time, yes? I know this is all a bit much, so if you feel like taking a short nap by your tent, by all means, go ahead. We'll keep the fire burning. Maybe I'll go do that. Sounds good to me, but first you'll probably want this. A bed?
It's your very own camping cot. You'll want to set it up in your tent before you lie down. Oh, and there's a few packages waiting in your tent as well. Just a few items that might be useful. So open packages and use things inside, press A. And when you're ready, you can crawl into bed. Got another big day ahead of us tomorrow, so rest up. Yes, yes, that's all from me now. Sweet dreams. I mean, I think my house is in a nice spot. Relatively close to the town center. What did they give me? A radio? I'll put it in the corner. That works. Alright, well, that'll do it for today. Thanks for watching, everyone. It's been a busy day. I'm kidding. I'm getting sleepy. Alright, now it begins. Hello, welcome to the island. So, looks like you've decided to make your own way in the world. Get out there, explore new frontiers. That's all the right, Daddy-o. You don't need to live by anyone's rules but your own. The world was made for exploring, you know? Living free, being out there, it's a great feeling. Yeah. But take it from a cat who's been on the road. Being by your lonesome can grind on the soul. You gotta make friends along the way. Rambling this crazy world is Squaresville without some pals. Yeah, man. Friends are where it's at. Speaking of rambling, I'm doing a bit of that myself, my bad. Maybe it's about time for you to wake up to your new life. Oh, but listen up, the rap I just gave you about friends, it's pretty key. You'll dig this island life a lot more if you share it with some friends, if that's your scene. Yeah, an island paradise with your best pals sounds pretty groovy to me. Cool. When you wake up, you'll be in sync with real time. Dig that island life and I'll catch you later. Well, are you in there? Oh, I hope I haven't woken you abruptly. But I do wish to discuss something with you. Yes, yes, I'll be here when you're ready. Ah, there you are. I hope you had a pleasant nap. Oh, well, I suppose it was a bit more than a nap, wasn't it? It's a brand new day. I slept that long? Yeah, it's quite normal to be worn out from such a long trip and a major life event. Speaking of which, I have a few more things that you might find useful as you adjust to your life in our little paradise. First, you'll need one of these, yes? It's your very own Nook phone. I had these especially made for island residents. Yeah, I want to make sure it's working, so could you try turning it on for me? These animations are so nice. Good, good. Looks like you're getting good reception as well. Okay, feel free to put it away now. Say, Will, have you ever used a smartphone before? Never! Sure, I have one of my own. Very good, then. This should be a breeze for you. In fact, I think you'll find it much more useful than the phone you already have. I doubt that. Ah, yes, yes. There's also a very useful app that contains advice for living here. Normally, this would not be free of charge, but as you're just getting started, consider it an extra bonus.
It's called Island Life 101, and it's a message delivery service of sorts. Feel like giving it a try, hmm? Sure. Okay, I'll need you to pull out your phone again so I can send you the app. Perfect, perfect. You've got the Island Life 101 app as well. You'll start getting messages once you're out and about doing things. Read as dumb as they arrive, hmm? Alright, that's enough about the app for now. I do have one more thing for you, however. It's a deed. Itemized bill. So this includes everything. Airfare, accommodations, labor tax, and of course your soul. I mean, Nook phone, hmm? Bringing your grand total to the modest sum of 49,800 bells. Bells? Oh, good one. Wait, you're being serious? Yes, of course. I can't believe I didn't think of this. Well, bells are a currency that can be exchanged for goods or services here on Shamblernia. Ah, but there's still the problem that you don't actually have any. Yes, of course. Well, no need to worry. I was prepared for exactly this type of tricky situation. For the getaway package, you can pay your fees with miles instead of the standard bells. I call this the extremely helpful service Nook Mileage Program. Nook Mileage? Well, it's quite extraordinary if I do say so myself. With the Nook Mileage Program, you can earn miles by simply living your life here on Shamblernia. I dare say the more you enjoy your island life, the more Nook miles you can earn. And you can use them to pay back your move-in fees and much more. So the bottom line is you'll need 49,800 to pay your move-in fees, but with this new service, would you believe it? It comes to 5,000 miles. I'll just go ahead and register you so you can pay in miles. Yes, yes, but there are more details available within your Nook phone. Just open the Nook Miles app, and you'll see you've earned some miles just for traveling to the island and joining the program. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must get back to a few other matters. But let me heartily congratulate you once again on your arrival. I'm so happy to have you as a resident of Shamblernia and a client of Nook Inc. My new life is underway. I can do whatever I want, woohoo, as long as I pay my bills. Okay. From now on, the island will match the flow of time in the real world. Do not touch the power button. Also save and quit your game after pressing minus. Alright, yeah, yeah. From Nintendo, what is this? Congratulations on your big move. I could give you a gift. Is this the Nintendo Switch, sir? Oh no, it's fine. I thought that was just a save option. Oh, it's just... Is this a DIY recipe? I wonder how I can memorize it. Apparently I don't have the DIY app. Okay. See, it's been that long that I forgot that was even a thing. Really? I don't know who these people are. There we go. I think that's for having the Happy Home DLC thing. Which I guess is another fresh experience. Alright. Yep. And Nook Miles, then trade in the various perks and goods at the Nook Stop in the Residence Services Center. Make the most out of island life, earned Nook Miles. I do have the DLC, yeah. Okay. Shells, number of items you have. Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of stuff I can do. Okay. Yeah. I love how they say make sure it's something that doesn't infringe on copyright. It's like... This is going right away. But this doesn't fill it completely. Starting a new design, so don't worry. I wish I could just download what I used to have, but I don't think there's a way you can export it. So I'll just have to redraw it. This work, it was like, all right, like this. LR. I forgot how to do the custom color thing. That's changing palette, but then there's a specific option. It's been ages since I've done this last. No, but see, that's all that does, and then... Alright, I'll just go for the closest one. That'll do, okay. Copy. I don't think I have the clothing design thing just yet, but okay. I'll earn it. Oh, you can do wear. Oh no, top face paint. No, we don't want that. Change design. Alright. Because this is effectively going to become the flag thing. Then I can alter the colors later when it's... I guess better looking. Alright. To be very rough with this. I wish it didn't smooth out the pixel art. I remember the first time I did this, no joke, I was doing it for an hour. Ugh. I'll try not to let it go for that long. How do you undo? Minus. I'm already not happy with it. Why must it be so tricky? Still. Sure. For now. I know I can make it better. I don't wanna bother yet. I might open up on my other Switch. Just the design and straight up copy it, because it took an hour to get it done. There you go. But it got an easy 500. That's the main reason I did it. I think I should be able to buy the DIY thing now. Ah, welcome. As you can see, it's quite cozy in here. It's funny how cozy doesn't always mean comfortable, hmm? Let me know if you need advice on how to spend your time on this island or anything else. If you need some advice about basic island materials, you should talk to Timmy. He can help you procure some of the essentials for thriving in our little paradise. If you want to earn some bells, he has a rather generous policy of purchasing just about anything. Not strictly advisable from a business perspective, but quite generous, yes, yes. Now, one more important thing. I'm offering a free DIY workshop that can help you really build out your island experience. I think it would be quite useful, so I hope you do take me up on it. Hmm? Yeah, do it. What would you like to talk to me about? I'm all ears. The DIY workshop. Yes, yes, the DIY workshop. Each participant will make and keep their own tools and receive a set of DIY recipes. I think it'll be quite useful for island life, hmm? So shall I put you down for the next available session? Yes. Yes, yes, that's the island spirit. I happen to be free right this very moment, so let's get started. Welcome to my DIY workshop. Oh, I suppose workshop is a bit overselling it, huh? When you see how simple it is to DIY or do it yourself, you'll understand what I mean. The basic idea is to gather materials, follow a recipe, and then craft using a workbench like this one. So today, we'll be constructing a fishing rod using common materials that you can find anywhere, yes? For this particular recipe, we'll require a mere 5 tree branches. Admittedly, it's a little flimsy. Now then, come see me when you collected the materials, hmm? Okay, yeah. Done. Ah, well, you found the necessary materials, hmm? Well then, let's get started on crafting that fishing rod, yes, yes. To begin, just select the project from the workbench and get started. Go ahead, give it a try. Okay. Oh, it doesn't let me speed it up the first time. I made a flimsy fishing rod. Yes, that was perfect. As you can see, crafting is quite simple, provided you have the correct recipes. And that concludes my free DIY workshop. Oh, there's one last thing. I have a few common DIY recipes for you, free of charge, naturally. I'll just send them to you, to your Nook phone. Would you mind opening it up? There we go. Splendid, thank you. The DIY app is now installed on your phone and ready for you to use anytime. And the flimsy fishing rod you crafted is yours to keep. It may not last forever, but it should serve you well for a little while at least. Speaking of fishing, I am no master angler, but perhaps I can give you a few tips. In my experience, you should aim for the front of the shadow of a fish when you cast your line. Yes, yes. I would love to see anything you manage to catch. I'm quite curious about the local fauna. Okay. Not yet. Hang on. I have that recipe on me now. Ah, okay. Sweet. I learned the DIY recipe for a simple workbench. Okay, it'll be a while. And that's... I need 2 more branches, but we need this. Oh, how silly of me to forget. I need to give you a brief introduction to that box there. That is a recycle box for the island residents to use. We'll be using it for items removed during construction and such. Yes, yes, if you see anything you like, feel free to take it home. The box gets full, we'll get rid of the oldest items first, so don't delay in picking out what you want. Yeah, I thought there were going to be building materials in here. Sometimes there's useful stuff. Okay, I guess the first priority is just to work on the shell thing. Because I don't think the museum is even here yet, now that I think about it. It's time to fish. Come here. Boy. Alright, so I have to pay attention to how the fish gets caught. Because in New Leaf it spins around in a circle and this looks different. Let's see. Oh yeah. Oh boy, a sea bass. It doesn't rotate the fish in a circle. Like, actually swims around in a circle. Yeah, okay, I see it, I see it. But I mean, it was on the DS, they did the best they could. I think these scaredy fish are just afraid of my huge bulging muscles, shorty! Bulging muscles. Oh yeah, the bait thing. I need a shovel, but just remembering I gotta create bait. Limited inventory space. It's okay. Ah, I don't have a slingshot. Oh, come on, not right away! Shit, 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 shit. Unbelievable. First trick. First trick. In the tent, in the tent! The first tree I decided to shake. Of course, trust my luck. Oh my god, that at least. Alright, well now I can safely shake this one and get everything I want out of it. I can't believe that happened. I'm gonna need a steady supply of this stuff. Please. There we go. How many is that now? That's an even number. Make 5 tools. Wow, walking around. Alright, I need to use the crafting bench now. I'm surprised I didn't get stung. Welcome, welcome. You don't waste any time, do you? We're still setting up, but for starters, we intend to offer a small selection of goods for our island residents. Space is limited right now, but we'll try to have some fresh stock each and every day. I'm sure you're busy, but feel free to take a look at some of the items we're selling. I'll take a look. Great. An oil barrel. A water cooler. Not just sells, we also buy, including stuff gathered. Because we want to support efforts to beautify this island. We'll even pay you a little bit in return for any weeds or trash you bring in. If you want to know whether we'll buy something, just ask. I mean, for now. Look at all the fine things you brought in today. Allow me to run the numbers. Pretty good. Okay. Getting 5,000 shouldn't take too long. First time you write something on the bulletin board. All right, that's easy. It's gonna be like a really bad drawing. It's just not used to the analog stick stuff. There we go, sure. It looks like Wariba as an octopus. I mean, it could happen. Apparently, I got the titles Rumormonger and Influencer. Okay, what else can we do as low-hanging fruit? Catch fish. Island togetherness. Talk to your neighbors every day. Alright, we can talk to a neighbor. Just making stuff, making tools. Weeder. Alright, weeding. Do some island cleanup. This is what I miss the most of this game, is just, oh, it has auto-stacking. Oh, I'm not getting punished for getting garbage. I loved New Leaf. I tried it before playing this again, and there's a lot of stuff in that game that I wish was in here, but I'll tell you what, the stuff I don't miss from it. Like, yeah, fishing out garbage and then being charged for it, like, that was not fun. Not the most fun thing to do. If you've ever done any weeding, removing weeds. And some of them are very, prickly. I wouldn't want to do it with bare hands. It's just... no. Gammy. Wait, you wish picking weeds was this easy? Yeah. Just effortless. Some of them you need a tool and you have to dig deep to get to the root. Very clean so far. Weeds that are between a rock path as well. Yep. I like the idea of gardening, I just... you know, I appreciate it, but it's just something that the effort, I don't like it. Particularly because my mom was just heavy into gardening growing up. Just keep plants and stuff inside. I remember having to go out there and just remove weeds. Probably gonna hang on to all these because you do need them for crafting. Nah, I'd rather just concrete jungle. It's low maintenance, no maintenance. It's the way to go. Hmm. I mean, I helped her careful with some of the plants at times. It's not like I did the boring work. It's just one more thing to care for, I guess. Like, I could do a small little bonsai tree or something. That'd be fine. As long as it's somewhere where I kind of sit there every day and get reminded. Or maybe herbs. Like, I could do a little herb thing. But nothing like a full-on backyard. Like, with flowers and stuff like that. How have I not gotten 50? I feel like I should have hit 50 already. Apparently not. I gotta be close. Yeah, I should say hi. Yeah, well, I'm getting a good vibe from that tent plot you picked for me. Thanks for the hand. Why, we've got to look out for each other here. If you ever need anything, don't be shy. Vroom! Oh, yeah. I was thinking about how to thank you, and I came up with a recipe for a leaf umbrella. Alright, so the first thing I thought was when I got here, now that's a lot of weeds. Now, that's kind of where I got this idea. It's a DIY project that uses weeds. Think about it. Weeds are the most abundant natural resource we have. May as well use them. Vroom! Okay. And I can make this as well. Huh? You almost peed yourself in surprise when I went vroom, and then again when you were typing it out. What? Why? It wasn't that loud, was it? Was it loud? I have compression on the mic, it should normalize it at the very least. This mic's pretty good. Now, if this was my old mic, yeah, probably would have been loud. This mic does a very, very good job. Oh, hey, Lelogats, thanks for the bits. How's it going? Yeah. We're past that era where I would have microphone fluctuations too often. It was such a normal, calm reading voice then. Vroom! I'm sorry. But, you know, if you know me at this point, I can't help myself. Yeah, I guess. I mean, like Tourette's. It's not the most random sound I've made. Did I misread this? Like, what's going on? Oh, sell them. Well, I may as well keep going at this point. That's fine. Hey, Lolo man, what's going on? How's things? I feel like I'm dressed too formal to be on an island. Just from this weeding activity, you know the pants at the very least are gonna get dirty. Thanks for the bits again, Lola Guts. I did run away from the last island. Yeah, I mean, it wasn't my fault though. It's just things did not look good with a solid gold clock in the middle of my living room. Things are things. How are we all doing? I'm doing alright. Happy the week's over. I'm just kicking back with this. I played a bit of Tunic earlier. Getting through the obscure puzzles. Can't believe how that game suddenly took like a sharp turn into Zelda 1 obscurity. Probably even more obscure. I feel like I'm trying to crack the Da Vinci Code or something. Really fish. Really fish. Really fish. Yellow perch. Those yellow birds have to sit somewhere. Well, I mean, at this point, $3,000 from just waiting. Wait, you just got done getting emotionally destroyed by anime. What are you watching? Why not? Brella, Ella, Ella, and Annette. Now I have a net. Now I can defend myself from the wasps. Lola Guts again with the bits. Thank you so much, dude. I just saw that pop up. Oh, that's what this looks like? I don't really use them, but for now, it's a novelty. Just finished Stein's Gate. I haven't heard of that one. I've been just watching One Piece in the 700s in terms of episodes. I'm getting there. I It's a psychological thriller about time travel. Interesting.
Is it one of these short ones or something that's ongoing and a heavy investment?
Messed your ass up. Oh boy.
Come here. What One Piece episode am I on? Give me a sec. I'll get that answer for you now. $7.74. I've been watching at least one a day. Sometimes I skip a few days and then watch a couple. But been getting there slowly. I do have my binge days though. So happy that I'm here, because it's so much easier to catch bugs. The problem I was having with New Leaf was just the tiny screen, and I guess the graphics are lower resolution, so sometimes things that are in the distance are harder to judge. Fish. Cat. There's a show called Dark on Netflix in German. But you're saying after episode 2, Lella will be hooked. Well, I feel like that name rings a bell for me. I've been on the fence about Netflix lately. Like, I'm on the verge of getting rid of it. What made me think about this is I got the email for PlayStation Plus's price increase, and I just cancelled it immediately. I was just, nah. The thing is, I don't even play multiplayer PlayStation games, and just what the price of that thing is nowadays is just, I don't think it's worth it anymore. And then it got me thinking, well, I don't really watch Netflix either. I might do a purge of my subscription services. It's a good start. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Lalo, you just did a purge already. Netflix survived it though, because there's still enough of interest for you. That's fair. I mean, I think for me, probably just anime and, I mean, I subscribe to YouTube now because I realize that YouTube's probably the thing I use the most. And then everything else, it's pretty much when I feel like watching a movie, but it's almost to the point where unless I get into a habit of watching movies frequently,
it's not worth the price. Shopping, yeah. Terminal service serves as an automatic bell dispenser. Or the bank of Nook. Working on a service which will let you redeem Nook miles for various things. Please take advantage of these wonderful service. Okay. Yeah, just this. Oh, yes! 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 A lot of people are saying that they've turned off The Witcher just because, out of principle, I guess, you know. Just the whole debacle with the actor and saying that they don't care about the source material. Nearly at the goal. Those aren't in your promotional materials. There might be a reason for that. Perhaps. But yeah, I mean, you know, you got a feel for Henry Cavill. He really did care about that series. Cared about it more than probably the writers did. It's just not good anymore, yeah. I can see that. The thing that kept Netflix around for me was just the fact that they got the rights to JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, so, you know, Stone Ocean aired on Netflix. I'm not sure they're gonna keep the rights. The fact that it's a gamer, actor, director jumping off the project because it doesn't follow the source of the characters to a decent adaptation. Yeah. Exactly. There goes my rod. But I get points for that, so that's fine. Get the shells. I've been checking out the One Piece live action thing. It's not bad. It's all right. It's like as a live action anime adaptation goes, done a decent job, but it's still, watch the anime instead. But, you know, it's not bad. Okay. I think I bought the full warrior outfit, I can't remember. Oh, thank you for the follow, Pokemon Fire. Chat, can you give me like 30 seconds? I just want to refill my beverage. I'm feeling a bit thirsty. So, give me 30 seconds to refill my drink. I don't know why I was just sitting there the whole time and like, man, I could use more beverage. I'm getting more Coke, but also I got a bottle of water, so then it's just like, once that's done, I have my water. Okay. Ah, that's much better. I'm trying my hardest not to miss fishing either. Because there's the whole catch in a row thing. Alright, I don't have a rod. I forgot to make one while I was in there. I think I need to get into a habit of just, like, once a week watching a movie or something. Or maybe once a fortnight, just so then I'm using these streaming services more. And can justify their costs. You watched 2 episodes of One Piece on Netflix and you wish you didn't. Couldn't understand the demographic for it. The acting because it's trying to mimic the animated faces felt awkward and cringy, but you feel that with most of the animation adaptation. Yeah, I mean, to each their own, but I think when you compare it to the other adaptations, it's not too bad. I think at the end of the day, anime adaptations are always going to feel like people in cosplay to a certain degree, and they're just trying to mimic the anime, but I mean, the setting is pretty nice. Like, I think it does a good job. And it's certainly not as bad as some of the other ones they've done. But I can understand if it's not your thing. It's been pretty well received. Yeah, it's probably going to be one of the first adaptations that, gets renewed for a second season. And you hated the way he said, "I am Monkey D. Luffy." Yeah. So, I mean, from what I've read, the casting is based off what the dude that created One Piece said in terms of what nationalities each of the characters would be. I think that dude playing it does an okay job, it's just, I think the demeanor is not quite 100%. But it's just one of those things, you're used to it sounding a certain way, and then when something deviates from it, it just sounds wrong. Like, take the Mario movie, for example. Like, it's not that Chris Pratt did a bad job. I think Chris Pratt was alright in the end, but I just could never get used to his voice as Mario. It just didn't feel right. Even though he had the mannerisms and stuff, sure, but it never sounded right. And I don't think anyone could do a Mario voice that sounds right. And I think anime has that same problem. Oh, you've never seen One Piece anime, so you couldn't compare? Oh, really? Okay. Yeah, I don't know.
Again, I didn't mind it, but I'll still watch them anime over it.
I think One Piece overall tells a good story. I was worried that it would be a bit like Dragon Ball filler when I first started watching it, but it's not. Its filler's not as bad as the original run of Dragon Ball.
Alright, pretty much there.
Oh boy!
You think filler is just an unfortunate side effect of designing anime for TV? I mean, it's just when the source material is still being written as the anime is being developed. That's usually what it comes from. I think that's why JoJo ends up being good and succinct, because it's written years in advance, and it'll be a while before they catch up to it. They don't have the moving thing right. Longer airtime means more money. Yeah, I mean, as long as it stays popular, sometimes people get tired of it. Damn, what's a low-hanging fruit I can do? Get more fish. Bugs. Alright, bug. Should do it. Probably won't be able to get much done here today. We'll get a decent session in. At least you've seen the villages, and I guess where things are starting off. Just on the first day, admittedly, there's not a whole lot you can do. Now, the thing is, I can't remember, but I should be constantly buying stuff from them. Oh yeah, I love oil drums. And, a water cooler, are you kidding? Ah. I
Okay, here we go.
DIY for beginners. Oh, I should have gotten the recipe.
I bought the slingshot, but not the recipe. It's okay. Support the local economy. And we're done. I hope you enjoy DIY even more with your new recipes.
Okay, and slingshot. No, I mean, I'm not gonna start laying out stuff just yet. Oh, hello, hello. What would you like to talk about? My moving fees. You like to pay your moving fees? Very well. You owe 5,000 miles. Ready to pay. Oh, thank you so much. Indeed, that is 5,000 miles and not a mile less. With that, your moving fees have been paid in full. This is a happy day for both of us. Hmm? Yes, yes. You're free and clear of debt. Living on a thriving scenic island. What could be better? Oh, that wasn't actually a rhetorical question. Let me be more specific. How is that tent treating you? It's fine, I guess. Oh, just fine? But consider doing fine on a formerly deserted island is actually quite good, hmm? Together, we're reshaping this barren wastella, I mean pristine paradise, into a lovely community. Wasteland. Ah, yes. But we mustn't rest on our laurels, hmm? Perhaps there is more we could do? Wastella, what is that? Yes, yes, I could. I suppose the time is right to discuss the possibility of building custom homes. Now, there are certain challenges to building fabulous homes in a remote location such as this. Challenges that do translate directly into costs, I'm afraid. But with zero interest financing and an extremely lax repayment plan, anything is possible. So, well, if you ever find yourself interested in a new home, come do see me. Do come see me. One more thing to share. We have a Miles redemption service for the Nook Miles you've collected. Once you access the Nook Stop, you'll be able to redeem your Miles for lots of interesting things. You'll be sure to check it out soon. Well then, I hope you continue your getaway package life. Okay. Wait, Timmy or Tommy were just staring into the viewers? They were? So it was really 4,500. Okay, plunge into debt! About my home. Oh, Will. You've made a decision about home ownership, ready to move forward into comfort and luxury. As fun as living in a tent can be, a house gives you more space and helps you put down roots. Now, building a house means taking out a new loan in the amount of 98,000 bells. So what do you think? Ready to build your home, sweet home? Yes. Thank you for your business. I'll get construction started right away. By the way, you get to choose from 8 different colors for the roof. Could you please select a roof color from the list, hmm? Oh, yeah, no, I just saw that, just staring down, jeez. Aqua. And I'll get that order in for you. Oh, one more thing. Homeowners get an automatic Nook Mileage program upgrade. Just give me one moment. Hmm. The plus program. Yes, yes, there we go. I've updated your program membership details. Now when you use the Nook Miles app, you'll have access to the Nook Miles Plus benefits. Nook Miles Plus includes a nifty way to earn additional miles for special circumstances. You'll see the details when you launch the app, so please give it a look when you can. That is all from me. Your wonderful new home should be ready tomorrow. Quite exciting, yes? Alright. Okay. Oh yeah, I was gonna ask, are you gonna be up for much longer?
because there's only so much I can do with this, and then I was either gonna say play Baldur's Gate or I'll do Pokemon. Like, I think I've kind of reached a point. Oh, there it is. There's a little bit more I can do today. I've messed up. The 100 in a row. Look at that. Just see what I mean? Look at the face. It's just constant skeptical face. Interesting face. How many knock miles do I have? I probably should have done this right away. Capture a memory, catch 5 bugs, plant shrubs, horse mackerel, earn bells by selling items. Okay. He looks like I just told him that Tom Nook is letting everyone off on the home loans. Just not a trusting character. Can I do this? It's like, okay. Wait, come back into frame. Kind of fading in and out for tonight. No, it's all good. Just figured I'd ask in case we're gonna be up. Okay, this does make it easier for thumbnails later. Particularly being able to hide the UI. Okay, 5 bugs. One. You got 3 points for messing with your passport. Oh. Wait, do I have that? Oh, that's here. Okay. There we go. Alright. It's another 300. Okay, now I have to care about this stuff. There we go. Oh, isn't that nice? It's a hell of an amount of money to find. Whole 5,000 bells. Really? Oh, I thought I could place it on top. Now, if I get thirsty, I can have a beverage or I can top up on oil, I guess. Yeah, well, that spot you found for me is incredible, thanks. I hope we can keep looking out for each other like this. It's good to have buddies, Shorty. Alright, I've got something here for you, Shorty. Thanks again for finding a place for my place. So this little mouse has just that permanent look on their face. That denim cap is perfect for Shamblonia. You can try it on by pressing X to open your pockets and then... Okay. Choose where if you want to put it on. You can always change it later if... You need to work out. Forgot to teach myself this. Sure, that works. Try not to run to scare the bugs. I get the feeling there's no bugs right now because most of them are the crickets or whatever it is, the underground one. There's no bugs anywhere. Either that or they're on the other side of the river and I can't get to them. I'd be right. Hello, bugs, where are you? I just need one more. I might just go inside my tent just to, I guess, reset. I think that works. No, inside the tent, not slap the tent. Is that the... Is that the museum music they're playing on the radio? Okay, well... I suppose before finishing up I should get all the peaches. Alright, I'm just clearly not gonna have bugs, so let's just gather peaches. I'm gonna have to make an effort to get all the fruit again. Ugh, that was fun on the launch of this game, everyone just asking what fruit you have and just trading. Pretty sure shaking these trees are safe. Don't think anything bad can come of this. Presents. Is this gonna land in an awkward spot? Oh, all right. What? I got a yellow frog costume. The other thing I gotta do is, like, leave a piece of fruit out so then it gathers ants. Maybe not yet. Or a turnip. I can't remember how it works. I want to sell. Day one, pretty much everything can go. Spoiled turnips, okay. I want to tell you something about the fruit you just sold me. When you eat food like fruit, you'll find yourself energized with more power than you might have imagined. Does anyone share that with you? What I mean is you could break open rocks, maybe dig up a whole tree if you had the right tool. Now it's fine for you to want to sell me your fruit. You should try eating it once in a while, too. Not quite enough to get that. Okay, what can I buy with this? Your account is now registered for mile redemptions. Yep. There it is, the pro editor, that's what we want. Hairstyle, the wetsuit is probably a good one too. Isn't there a storage upgrade? Alright, for now, this. Yeah. Okay, and now. Wetsuit, just so we can go swimming easy. Okay. Tool ring, it's essential. Tool ring? Oh, right. Pocket organization guide is what I want. That's the one that gives me more storage. Okay. It's been that long that I don't remember, but I got it now. Wah, wah. The ring is nice too. It is, but I think I can do without it. Storage. It's more required. Pop a balloon. Oh, right, the stuff on the other side of the river. Look at how many peach trees are on the other side of the river. Kind of an insane amount. I mean, okay, I'll hang on to these, but then the rest can go. I need storage. Just stick the basics. The other net I have is about to break anyway. This animation is so nice. Catch fish. Okay. I'll do ocean fishing since it wants a horse mackerel. But yeah, tomorrow I'll have the swimsuit, so I'll be able to do ocean scavenging and all that stuff. Dab, not bad. Gotta keep collecting shells because they count as well. I'm surprised I got that, but it's probably just a sea bass. At this point, I just want anything and everything. I'm just glad that I'm not missing these, because now it makes me feel better, because in New Leaf I was just constantly missing bugs, but I think it's just a matter of the tiny screen and the lower resolution graphics. I haven't really missed one yet. Maybe I'm just getting old. Getting those old man eyes. So I can just grab this in a minute. Season that all, and I have to get my eyes checked. Yeah, I probably should. I found a creature. Let's have a look, shall we? Butterfly. What? This is new. Oh, what a catch. I believe this is a yellow butterfly. This island can support a yellow butterfly. Well, who knows what other fantastic creatures we might find living here. Well, I have an idea. An old friend of mine runs a museum, and I'd like to send it to him for a closer look. Would you be okay with that? Yes? Thank you. I promise that I'll take extra good care of yellow butterfly. You can donate stuff already? That reminds me. This is no way tied to a generous donation, but I have a useful app to show you. But then we don't get the thing from Blathers. I sent you the Critopedia app. It's a terrific resource for an aspiring island researcher such as yourself. This one app, you'll get all the important details about bugs, fish, and creatures you catch. I do hope you continue to fill it up with your discoveries and share them with me. I'm sure I'll be able to come up with some kind of initial reward. Another creature? Well, let's take a look at that one as well. Oh, what a catch. I do believe this is a common butterfly. Would you mind if I sent this magnificent creature along to my museum creating friend as well? Okay. Thank you. I promise that I'll take extra good care of your common butterfly. Oh, by the way, have you been taking advantage of my DIY workbench lately? I have. That's great. Come to think of it, I have seen you tinkering around a bit over there. Keep up the good work. That reminds me, I've been meaning to share more DIY recipes with you. Mind turning on your phone? I just sent you a number of DIY recipes that require wood along with the recipe to craft an axe. Yes, yes, I think an axe would come in quite useful on this island. Because of so many other things are made out of wood. Hmm? Hope you'll keep bringing me new discoveries to examine. It's all part of the island experience. Yes, yes. Okay. I found a creature. The sea bass. Oh, what a catch. I do believe this is a sea bass. Would you mind if I sent this to... Yeah, yeah. An axe on first day compared to New Leaf. I did not get an axe in New Leaf. That's what it comes down to. I have a proper reward this time. I'm giving you some red wind flower bags, just a sampling of a product we sell. Go ahead and do some planting, and after a few days you'll have beautiful blooming flowers. Anyway, give it a whirl. If you enjoy gardening, stop by and buy more. Okay. This dude's like a drug dealer. He gives you something for free, and then just gets you hooked. I found a creature. Dab. Oh, what a catch. I didn't believe this is a dab. Do you mind if I sent this? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, remember the flower samples I gave you? I forgot to mention something. The flowers that grow will be very strong. They'll spring up even if you just plant them and forget them. But if you water them every day, that's where the magic happens. Watering opens up the possibility of propagating and crossbreeding your flowers to develop rare colors. And how might you water them, you ask? Well, I've just sent you a DIY recipe for a watering can. My accountant warned me about giving this sort of thing away for free. But you've collected creatures from me well, so this is part of the island give and take. I hope you'll keep bringing me new discoveries to examine. It's all part of the island experience. Yes, yes. You got the 5 stars without knowing, so you almost shat your pants when you saw Lily of the Valley on your cliffs. Yeah, they just grow in random places and then you can move them and you get, eventually, a bunch of them. You can make things look nice. Butterfly, butterfly, carry. Okay. It's good to know that I can donate already. Okay, I need more tree branches, but I can have a stone cutter axe. Cause then I can get wood. Okay, the safe tree was this one. Getting there. I don't think I ever got all the flowers, just kind of got lazy with it. But I'll try and do a better job this time. Thank you. be enough to craft some stuff. I need to get to the point where I can get a shovel. Softwood yet. Okay. Yeah, shovel. Because I think if I hit a rock with a stone cutter axe, it's bad news. I think I should get out of this frog outfit, because then it'll give me one more slot of inventory space. Yeah. Okay. So you know how the closer you get to the villager, Zayma asks, hey, I want to give you a nickname, what should it be? And for one villager, they were like, whatever, I'm going to kick you out eventually. You wrote bitch tits, and for some reason, half the new villagers started calling you that, even when the villager moved out. Yeah, because they share that. It's, you know, hey, I heard so-and-so called you that. So then they all start calling you that. That's gonna stick around for a while. It'll always be around for some sort of extent. Eventually it should vanish, but... be careful what you allow people to call you. But they didn't ask, some of them call you Butterbean, one calls you Muffin, and the rest just call you Bitch Tits. Maybe they just figured out what's going on. It's like, you know. They knew you didn't care about that villager, and it's a protest thing now. Storage. Well, there goes that. Damn it, I heard a balloon. As I went in. It's not craftable yet. Since it's only a certain amount you can get per day. find it funny that multiple types of wood come from one tree. Like, how does that work? Magic. Oh no, you get it from the different parts of the tree. Shouldn't all butterflies be yellow? Because they're butter. Get it? Haha. Ah, there it goes again. My first villager called me Chicky Po. It was a chicken. On my first island, my first villager was a chicken. Okay, I finally got it. The starters that I got, it was like the chicken and it was Rod, the mouse. So I had a mouse as well. Those were the two starters I had. Rod stuck around until the very end. Yeah, I think Snake came later. Now I can just pick it up. That worked. Damn it, buying. Like, what am I gonna spend 5,000 bells on this early? You've been trying to gift your villagers so they give you their photo. Random is random. Just have to keep trying for the one you want. I found a creature. Horse mackerel. Oh, what a catch. I do believe this is a whole smack roll. Okay. Okay. Hold the phone, someone's calling. Blathers, is that you? Oh, what splendid timing. Yes, do you remember the venture we discussed? Well, it's come to fruition. I'm currently stationed on an island that we've decided to call Shamblonia. Yes, the local fauna are as abundant as expected, just as I told you. How many precisely, you ask? Well, there's no way of knowing just yet. But I have received, 5 outstanding specimens so far. What? Seriously? Well, that is very exciting. Oh, but you'll have to excuse me, I'm with a customer right now. I'm sorry to keep you waiting. That was my friend Blathers, the one who curates a museum. Believe it or not, he's going to come to our island to help identify and preserve the local creatures. Yeah, but I could use your help, Will. The tent. Since you've done so much scouting and collecting today, would you be able to find a spot for Blathers? We'll need a good-sized space to really build out a world-class museum, so keep that in mind. It's exciting. It's all coming together. Yes. Okay, so I'm gonna make, the museum is going to be here. I need space, though. Pretty much, there's gonna be a... little bit further back. There we go. Too close to the plaza, really? It has to be one tile away. Okay, I guess so. Alright, there we go. Yeah, that works. Yes. Blathers can set up his place now. Okay, so Main Street goes up. And then we're gonna do a turn. Which will lead to bridge 1. Kinda got a layout in mind. Street keeps going. We'll reach the end here, turn down. And then go across again. Whatever the distance is, it'll work. And then this is the road from the airport, so they'll go straight up. I'm planning. Unlike the first one I did, there was a lot of moving going on, but not this time. And then, I'll put the shop here. And then probably another store here. Maybe a little park here. I'll figure it out. But I'm keeping residential in a grid this time. It's not exactly a uniform grid. But that's fine. Okay. Crap. I wish there was a little cursor that showed you where you were about to plant it. But there is one complaint I have about this. It's just, it doesn't really accurately provide it. It's okay, I can move him later. Oh, well, I take it you found a suitable spot for Blathers to set up, hmm? I did. I knew I could count on you, thank you. I'll let Blathers know. He can move in as soon as he wants. Okay, well, that's it. I did the creature thing. Flimsy watering can, flimsy axe, got it. Slingshot, got it. I honestly forgot what flower type I got there. I probably should have checked before I got to it. It's okay. I don't remember the flower type. I guess I could roll with it and just do that. Right now I'm just trying to earn easy ones. Trees in my way. Oops. Not too far off. I need one more shell and then I can get that as well. There we go. I need to get inventory space. This is a bit of a struggle now. I have too much junk on me. Or at the very least, like, I don't know. Just some sort of storage. I'm good. Alright, not that. I'm doing the wrong thing. Decent. Okay, that's another one. Balloons.
place furniture outside. I don't have much more furniture. I guess I could take this cardboard box, it would count. It's one less thing. Well, I mean, for now. Right? It's like, yeah, hey, this stuff part of the construction. There we go. It fits in. It's not inside the rope, but it's okay. Lucky. Okay, there's one piece of furniture per day. I need to, however, be ready. Money. Where is the furniture? Oh, big fish. Effectively, I see this. Hey, what money? I'm pressing the wrong button. I know. Pressed the wrong button. So I've been pressing A repeatedly over and over again. Just sometimes pick up is A, which is the same as interact, and that's just what I thought it was for a sec. I swear at least one tree had furniture, but maybe I'm wrong. Oh, there's... Bagworm. I'll start putting stuff that I'm gonna donate to Blathers outside of the museum. I think I've shaken every tree. There we go. Got it. I got a fridge! Yeah, a whole ass refrigerator just falling from the tree. I'm already living large. Thank you.
The refrigerator, should I change? What? What? What do you mean? What? Why is a fridge a wardrobe? Has that always been the thing? Oh, yeah, I'll open the fridge. I think I need a change of clothes. That's strange. Nearly there. What else can I do? I mean, it's buy stuff, bugs, plant. Plant trees or shrubs. You had the same what the fuck, man, when you interacted with an ice cream stand that was like, you want to change? Yeah, I feel like that's just a moment where they were just like, screw it, it needs to do something. We'll just make it a closet. So, just place item, place item. Like, I'm not sure if these things are going to be donated, the ones that I gave. Let's see. Balloon. Where is Balloon? Oh, over there. Good stuff. How do you say balloon in Spanish? Vejiga. Dinnerware. Wow. Damn. No one's here. They're all out. Have dinnerware. Have all the essentials now. To the stack. I'm gonna put this away. There we go. Right now, I just want the miles, but also... Well, I gotta go make another. DIY recipes, that's good timing. Okay. I want to sell. That, and that. Can't make any more, otherwise I would mass craft them. Once I got the house, the storage will, you know, not be an issue. It's just right now, yeah, I'm lacking it. What? Hey! Oh, that's bad. There we go. Do I have that here? Let's see. I do not. Okay. That's most of the butterflies, if not all of them. Tiger beetle. £9 first. Okay. It's the front of the donation line. I need more fish. That in the background. Tiger butterfly. Is it? Yeah, I mean, I think they sell for okay. It's just the common ones that don't really sell much. That's another one. Alright, two more. You know what? There's already two here. Let's just be quick. It's not close enough. Oh look, it's my favorite kind of fish. if I remember correctly, you leave garbage and you're gonna get stuff, so. I'm gonna do. Wait, there's a bug. I see a bug that I don't have. Dropped a tire here. I already had it. Because it's gonna drop. I'll pick it up when I get outside. The old man panic voice over the bug I already had. Is it an old man panic voice? I feel like I could sound much older than that.
Oh no! Oh no!
I don't know. I don't know how I can sound much older. Old will not dying. Well, same difference. Okay, we got a new one. Trash fishing. Trying to do my best to just not mess up as much as I can with the fishing. Okay, another fish. Wait, they count as furniture. I'll take it. Alright, cool, I got enough of the storage upgrade. Excellent furniture. Just feel the love on that decoration. There we go, that's the big one. Now generating pocket organization guide. Ah, okay. I see, this totally makes sense. Now I know how to use my pockets. I learned some tricks for organizing my belongings. I bet I can carry more stuff now. Yeah, there we go. Sweet. Okay. Okay. Well, I think this is a good a start to any. Solid 3 hours ish. Yeah, tomorrow museum will be up and I can make more progress on things. Hopefully I can get the axe tomorrow, and then I can start chopping away the trees and lay out a path of sorts. I think this time I might use the pattern browser thing. Maybe I can design my own, we'll see how I feel. Okay, but that will do it for this initial stream of New Horizons. Hope you enjoyed it, everyone, especially if you're watching later on YouTube. If you did, remember, if you want to support the content channel, whatever I got going here, just clicking buttons and stuff will appease YouTube, but also help me out a lot. So thank you to those that do that. And yeah, if you want to watch me play something else, I'm sure two other videos have popped up as well, so hope you check them out. But till next time, see ya, YouTube.